Sire, the story of the boy who chased the sunset until it chased him. One of my favorite artists in hip-hop and in general is Jaden Smith, the band himself, the icon. And some of my favorite albums as well would be Sire and ERYS. These two albums, Sire and ERYS, polar opposites. ERYS is Sire backwards, and Sire is Jaden's middle name. Jaden Christopher Sire Smith. These are two of my favorite albums of all time, with great sounds, a great story, and a great connection between the two, Sire and ERYS. Sire coming out on November 17th, 2017, and ERYS releasing on July 5th, 2019. Sire is a story of teenage heartbreak and sadness and lost love. ERYS is the exact opposite. ERYS is the alone, gritty. In this video, we'll document the story of Sire, the story of ERYS, and everything in between. The connection between the two and where we're at today with the two. Sire is Jaden's debut album. Prior to Sire, he had released two mixtapes, Cool Tape Volume 1 and Cool Tape Volume 2. Cool Tape Volume 2 being one of my favorite tapes ever, with very good songs in there, including Keep Your Love, Let It Breathe, Zoned, and Fire. Artistically, these albums are very good, in my opinion. From the four-part intros, four-song, four-part intros, B-L-U-E and P-I-N-K, B-L-U-E being on Sire and P-I-N-K being on ERYS, these extravagant, epic intros with everything from melodies to great energy to great production, great backing vocals from his sister Willow. They are great intros to each album. Like I said before, these two albums are connected. They are polar opposites of each other. Sire and ERYS are opposites of each other. ERYS is Sire spelled backwards. Sire came out first. ERYS is the exact opposite of Sire that came out almost 2 years after Sire first released. They are opposites, and you can hear it in the sound of the music and the messages as well. Sire even features on the track again on ERYS, which was a single for the album ERYS coming out in July of 2019. Again was a track which was half of each style, half ERYS, half Sire, the first half being the more raw, gritty ERYS style, and the second half being the more melodic, raw, laid back Sire style. And on the end of the track, ERYS comes back, the voice of ERYS, the raw, gritty voice of ERYS comes back on the track at the very end of again, and says, "Get out of here, big drip only." Big drip only is one of the kind of mottos of ERYS, of the ERYS era and of the ERYS alter ego. So before we dive into Sire and the connection between Sire and ERYS, I want to talk about CTV2 first. I have not heard CTV1, but CTV2, it is 8 tracks. It's a short mixtape, 8 tracks, 34 minutes, but he touches a lot on love and his relationships in this short mixtape. On the 10.5 minute long song, Let It Breathe, he talks a lot about a relationship with a girl that is older than him, and I think that could have been the start of Sire, or at least had to do with some of Sire.
No, yeah, we were really good in pairs, but, you know, every relationship has ups and downs, and the downhills are what...
Before he released Sire, he released one of the lead singles, Icon.
What you call an icon living? Start a record label, Miss Fish just did it.
Icon is his biggest song to date. Icon has over 159 million views on YouTube. This song was very big around 3 years ago. The song totally exploded when he released it as a single. It's the biggest song off of Sire and bigger than any other song on ERYS as well. Icon was actually not meant to be a huge hit song. They did not expect it to be a huge hit song. The way it was released was actually they lost the music video for a different song. Either they lost it or didn't want to release it, or something went wrong with it. So they didn't have the music video for the single for a song they wanted to release. I think they were going to release Batman, but they ended up releasing Icon instead. So they released Icon with the video. He had that video. They weren't going to release it until after the album was already released, but they released it prior to the album coming out as a single, and the song, and the song exploded and did very well. The album comes in at 17 songs and an hour and 10 minutes long. Pretty long for an album that is just 17 songs. Over an hour long, it's pretty long for just 17 songs. There are two songs on here that are very long, one being 90, coming in at 7 minutes and 48 seconds long, and the second one being Lost Boy, which is almost 10 minutes long.
When I open my eyes, I wish to see you, but your phone doesn't ring and you're gone all the time. Well, I guess you're somewhere with your crew.
There's only two features on here, and those features being ASAP Rocky and Rory. ASAP Rocky being the one feature on Breakfast. Breakfast is the fifth track right after the extravagant intro of BLUE. It gets right into Breakfast, and the transition from E to Breakfast is very good. It transitions very well from E right into Breakfast, right into the production and the vocals as well. ASAP Rocky does not have a verse on here. He just has some vocals that are kind of in the background as the song starts to slow down midway through the song, but did no verse, but he still contributed to this song.
Riding the metro, we booming. All the misfits come together in a Tesla, and we zooming.
Rory has a very good feature, very good melodies on the track Falcon.
On the road, Dowson, I got you all bouncing. Falcon.
I am not afraid to walk the lonely road.
Which is the seventh song on Sire, Falcon being a more energetic song. Definitely one of my favorites on here, Falcon featuring Rory, with a great feature from Rory. The transitions on Sire from song to song, mainly in the first half, really after the big intro that is BLUE, the transition from E to Breakfast is very, very, very good. The beat is still kind of connected from E to Breakfast. The beat is by the end of E, the beat really transitions to like the same beat to where the same start of the beat for Breakfast, the start of the beat for Breakfast and the end of the beat for E is the same, flows perfectly right into each other. At the end of Breakfast, Jaden makes a pretty confident statement. At the end of Breakfast, he asks a question. He says, "So, do you think you can save rap music?" And then the next song is Hope. So the first line in Hope and part of the hook is "Baby girl, I just hope." So going from Breakfast to Hope, it's "So, do you think you can save rap music?" And then it goes right into Hope, "Baby girl, I just hope." So he answers the question right at the start of the next song. The end of Hope is really the end of this little transition part for the album. The transitions are still good but not great throughout, and there's no like questions being asked and then answered in the beginning of the next song. But at the end of Hope, he says, "So, do you party much?" And then we get to one of the more energetic, I'd say kind of like a party kind of track on Falcon. He says, "So, do you party much?" And then the beat for Falcon comes on immediately after, and then the beat for it really just starts quiet and then gets a lot louder as the song progresses in the first few seconds. Get into more of who Sire is and the story of Sire now. Sire is Jaden's alter ego. Like I said in the beginning, it's his middle name. It is his alter ego. Sire is a love story. The four-part intro, BLUE, really sets the tone for the rest of the album with the love theme. Sire to me is a story of Sire and Jaden chasing a girl and trying to get her to fall in love with him and to get into a relationship with him. He chases her throughout the entire album, throughout almost every song, and on the song 90, he gets very specific, and Jaden goes in depth on what makes Sire Sire at the end of the track 90. 90 is one of the longer tracks and more focused tracks on this album, more focused about love, focused on the relationship that Sire is chasing. He says, "Sire, passion, pain, and desire." The sunset, as seen in the album cover, the nice sunset in the background of the album cover, is also a reoccurring theme throughout the entire album. Sire, the boy who chased the sunset until it chased him. To me, Sire is Jaden's love for this girl and this relationship that he either had or is still chasing, or had and is, or it fell through and he is chasing it now to get back to what he had before. consistently throughout the entire album. Sire is described as the boy who chased the sunset until it chased him. The music video for 90 actually came out over 2 years after, just about 2.5 years after the original Sire album released. It came out last year in May of 2020. He describes 90 as a poem by Sire. And in this video, he is seen chasing this girl. And he ends up, at the end of the video, watching the sunset. The song and video for 90, to me, is about teenage heartbreak, romance, and chasing love and lost love. At the end of the video, after the girl is seen running away from Jaden, he is gazing at the sunset, and he is shown, and it says, "But he was happy." Sire, to me, is a character and alter ego that will most likely show up in probably every Jaden album or mixtape in the future. It has so far since Sire. There's a song titled Sire and Abbey Road on the Sunset Tapes, A Cool Tape Story. Sire features on ERYS on the track Again, and Sire is also, there's actually a song with Sire in the title, The Birth of Sire, on CTV3, Cool Tape Volume 3. On the end of 90, Jaden actually says, "Sire still exists in the mist and the fog. Poets say he pretended to be gone, but I say he is eternally lost." Sire is kind of, and he says it in a clip I will show soon, Sire is kind of a myth, a legend, as Jaden states, a myth, a legend, and kind of a theme that I think will show up repeatedly in Jaden albums and mixtapes, or even songs, any song, in the future.
He's kind of like a myth, like a legend, you know, like in the sunset, and he just represents, you know, broken, lost teenage youth, lost love.
Just about a year after Sire first released, Jaden released The Sunset Tapes, A Cool Tape Story, which was the transition tape between Sire and ERYS. Now this was a mixtape, so the effort wasn't totally there, but the purpose of this mixtape was to transition from Sire to ERYS, from the Sire sound to the personality and alter ego of Sire to the sound of ERYS, and the alter ego of ERYS to the new theme and the new person of ERYS. This mixtape had many great tracks, including Soho, A Calabasas Freestyle, and Plastic as well. Many great tracks on here. Play This on a Mountain at Sunset is another great track, a longer one. There's some longer tracks on here, 5-6 minutes long, and some shorter ones as well. This tape has some slower tracks, kind of similar to some on Sire, like 90 and Fallen, and some more energetic ones like Icon and Watch Me, like Plastic and A Calabasas Freestyle. This tape really served its purpose. It's a great sound to transition from Sire to ERYS, and you can hear in the background of songs like Plastic, Soho, and A Calabasas Freestyle, you can hear the voice of ERYS, the gritty and deep auto-tuned voice in the background of these songs starting to come to life.
Intentions, burning white picket fences.
And it first shows up here and helps to transition from Sire to ERYS, and we ease from Sire to ERYS with that gap, the almost 2 year gap between the two albums, but we have the mixtape in between, which was a perfect transition sound wise and aesthetic wise, style wise, from Sire to ERYS. So we transitioned from Sire to ERYS with The Sunset Tapes, A Cool Tape Story, with that sound and that character that was in between Sire and ERYS, not really a fully developed character, but that mixtape was Sire turning into ERYS. Now ERYS is the exact opposite, like I said, of Sire, the opposite, alone with friends, and he states that throughout the album a lot. ERYS in the city with the boys. Instead of spending time in nature or chasing a girl, ERYS comes off as someone who does not really need a girl, doesn't care as much about love, and is more with friends and the boys, as he states in many songs throughout the album. He doesn't care about love as much. ERYS is very ignorant, cocky, and aggressive. A lot of these songs in here are very aggressive, like Riot and Noise and I on the intro, the four-part intro, P-I-N-K. One more thing that makes ERYS very unique and very different from SYRE is the autotune that is used throughout the entire project. It was also used on the ERYS Is Coming three-track single, which one track actually appears on the deluxe version, which we'll get to soon, the three-track single, New Direction, Pass, and Beautiful Disruption, were the three singles that were released on ERYS Is Coming, which released 3 months prior to ERYS's release. ERYS Is Coming was a three-track taste of what ERYS was going to be, the style, and the sound of ERYS. The very high autotune with the deeper voice and the extravagant autotune is seen throughout the entire project on every single song. He really doesn't use, maybe on Summertime in Paris, but really for the most part, he really doesn't use a voice on here without a lot of autotune. On tracks like ERYS, the title track, and Noise, and Riot as well, he uses a lot of autotune, same on the song I Drip or Is. I Drip or Is also comes to the, or also goes to the theme of Big Drip and Big Drip Only, which is one of the mottos or themes throughout the album as well. Big Drip Only, which I think goes to and reinforces the theme of, you know, not needing love as much, not going towards love as much, and, you know, kind of alone with the boys instead of chasing the girl like SYRE would be doing. Kind of the opposite, the exact opposite of what SYRE would be doing. ERYS is more in the city with friends, you know, messing stuff up in the city, doing stuff like that instead of chasing love and spending time in the hills. I think Jaden executed very well on the cocky, ignorant, and aggressive style with the autotune, which I think actually makes for a very good sound on this project. The style is very in-your-face and aggressive, ignorant, louder, in-your-face. The track Noise is very, very loud. I like this track from the start. Noise is very, very loud. Tyler fits perfectly into the track. Noise, Riot, I Drip or Is, some very aggressive and loud tracks in here, as well as some parts on the title track ERYS as well. Same with Got It and Fire Department as well, which Fire Department is a different track, a very different track. It is kind of a pop punk inspired track. It's shorter, and the last 20 to 30 seconds are slower and slowed, but very aggressive songs and here, louder and more in your face with the style on this album. There is one track that is a lot slower than the rest and really kind of does resemble ERYS and really kind of gets away from the ERYS theme. I think this might be SYRE kind of starting to show up. It doesn't feature SYRE like the track Again does, but I think this is where SYRE kind of pops up. Summertime in Paris with Willow. It's a very slowed, less auto-tune, and more melodic track. It kind of really is a SYRE-style track. Not as much, but it kind of gets away from the ERYS theme. I think it's midway through. SYRE tries to come back on this track, but then after that, he doesn't really come back. We get to the songs Blackout and Pain, which are a lot more closer to the ERYS style. There are some melodies there, but a lot more auto-tune there, and they're more aggressive in parts of those songs as well.
Summertime is meant to fall in love. I wrote you a poem for your surprise.
But SYRE tries to come back on Summertime in Paris featuring Willow. I think it's a very good song, and SYRE tries to come back, but then ERYS comes back. That occurs many times on this album, as well as on the track Again. And then SYRE also reappears on the last track of the album, the title track ERYS. He concludes the album with SYRE coming back at the very end. Like I said, SYRE comes back on the last track ERYS, comes back and talks about love, really kind of concludes the album talking about love and some more SYRE-like topics, talking about love and heartbreak, kind of makes an appearance at the end here, and that's where the album finishes. Aside from the deluxe version, which the deluxe version has three more tracks added on. One is Beautiful Disruption, which is a very ERYS style, aggressive, loud, in-your-face track, 2.5 minutes long, a great song. I do love that song. Very ERYS style song. Another theme that he mentions throughout the entire album is vision. Vision is mentioned throughout almost every track and throughout the entire album almost. On the album cover for ERYS, it's very different from SYRE, and it goes back to the theme of not needing a girl and being in the city instead of in nature on a hill, watching the sunset. Sire on the album cover is watching the sunset. You can see the beautiful sunset on the album cover. However, Iris is in the city on top of a building on a couch looking up at the sky. So it kind of resembles Sire looking at the sky, but he's on top of a building on a couch in the city, not on a hill in nature looking at the sunset. He's looking at the pink sky on the cover of Iris. Touching on the features on here, very quick. Trinidad James actually had a very good feature on here on the track Mission with a good hook towards the end of the song. Willow had a very, very good feature. She fit very well into the track Summertime in Paris. Tyler, the Creator also fit very well into the song Noise. The energy that he brought was very good on that song. Kid Cudi had one of my favorite features ever from anybody on the track On My Own. Fit very well into there. Had a very, very good hook and good melodies, good humming as well. Did a very, very good job on that track. On My Own is one of my favorite tracks on the entire album. Jaden killed it. I think lyrics, everything came together perfectly on My Own. And then ASAP Rocky has two features, one on the deluxe version, which is the remix to Ghost, his single Ghost, which did not appear on this album, but the remix appeared, which is more of a Iris-style song. The remix appeared on the deluxe version, just the deluxe version, the last track. ASAP Rocky had a pretty good feature on there. I think the remix is better than the original song. The original song I do like, though. It's just a loose single, though. And then he had a feature on the track Chateau. Fit very well into it. Had a very good hook as well. It was a very Iris-style song with the auto-tune from Jaden. Iris, to me, is what Sire turned into after the heartbreak. Sire still exists, but I think for a period of time, Sire turned into Iris. And I think Sire wanted to come back, but Iris was holding them back. And Iris was what Sire turned into for a little while in a period of time. I can picture Sire coming back as well as Iris in the future. I'd be very stoked for more albums from Jaden with either of these styles. I love both styles. I think both styles are great, great styles. I love the autotune on Iris. I think he did a very good job executing with the autotune on Iris. But concluding the documentary here, Iris is who Sire turned into, in my opinion. That is how I see it. That is who he turned into after the heartbreak and the love. And as he grew a little older, we had a bit of a gap, a year and a half, almost 2 years between Sire and Iris. I think Sire turned into Iris after a little bit of time, after the heartbreak, after growing a little bit older. I think he transitioned into Iris. I can picture Jaden bringing back either of these characters in the future. I would love to see it musically. And stylistic wise, I would love to see it. I would love to see where he goes with these styles in the future and with these characters and alter egos as well. Overall, I love both of these styles and both of these characters that he portrays in both of these albums, as well as the in-between transition style on the Sunset Tapes, A Cool Tape Story. Concluding it here though, thank you for watching. Thank you for watching the documentary, especially if you made it all the way to the end. We touched on a lot. We didn't go too in depth, but these are my thoughts and my opinions on the story of Sire and Iris, from Sire to when it was released up until Iris, the album that came out just about 2 years ago now. Two great albums, in my opinion. Two great characters that I hope to see more of in the future with Jaden and his style. Thank you for watching. Drop down your thoughts on this documentary and on the story of Sire and Iris and this music as well and these characters. Drop your thoughts on them down in the comment section. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you again in future videos.